We all know diamonds are a girl's best friend, but otters have a passion for pebbles. And it's a love that can last for months, some think years. Why do sea otters bond with stones? A clue is in their diet. A sea otter's lunch comes to the table ready for a fight. Clams, abalone, snails, all heavily armed with thick, tough shells. And sea otters need to eat a quarter of their body weight of them every day. That's the equivalent of a man dining on over 30 T-bone steaks. So, to crack so many hard shells, sea otters have evolved to have super tough teeth. In fact, the enamel in their teeth is over 2.5 times tougher than ours. Extra layers of a special protein-rich gel prevents otter teeth from cracking as they bite down on their prey. But for some meals, even reinforced teeth are not strong enough. For those really tough shells, the sea otter uses a tool. And their tool of choice is a pebble. Other than dolphins, sea otters are the only marine mammal that use tools. But this tool is not just any pebble. It has to be heavy and hard enough to use as a hammer or an anvil without shattering. It must be smooth enough so the sea otter can hold it in their paws. And small enough to keep in a unique pebble pocket sea otters have under one of their limbs. In fact, when they find the perfect pebble, it is so precious, they may keep it for up to a year or more. And to improve their agility and dexterity with their favorite tool, sea otters practice by juggling with their pebbles. And although no one really knows why, so do river otters. Even though they don't use a pebble as a tool for getting to food or have a pebble pocket. Maybe otters just like juggling. Over 72 million at last count. That's 3 sheep to every human living down under. Oi! Just outside Melbourne, farmer David has 500 sheep. They've been out in the fields, and now it's time for every last one to return to the pen. It's an impossible job for David, but not for his incredible sheepdogs. Do dogs wrangle sheep? This is the sheep herding dream team. Leader of the pack is Checkers, a 13-year-old border collie cross, followed by 4-year-old Kelpies, Cisco, Pillar, and Blue Tack.
Hop up.
And of course, Farmer David.
Hop up, Phil.
Good girl. They're pretty keen to see some sheep now, I reckon, aren't you?
There are 344 official breeds of dog, but only 40 can do what these guys do. That's because they share an instinct for pack hunting, to herd prey before a kill. But shepherds like David have figured out how to tap the dog's instinct and high energy.
The dogs are natural hunters, and it's a matter of curbing that hunting instinct. You try and reduce the killer in them and just harness the herding instinct that goes with pack behaviour. Yeah?
Dogs of this breed are naturally obedient, and Farmer David uses this to temper their instinct to kill. From 1 year old, once past those playful puppy days, sheepdogs are trained to obey the leader of the pack, always rewarded for obeying the top dog's commands. The top dog here being Farmer David. And Farmer David says sheep are strictly off the menu. The dogs approach the 500 sheep. As they do, the sheep huddle together for safety. If the dogs get too close, the sheep will scatter. But if they hang back too far, the flock can split into smaller groups. New research has shown that the sheepdogs constantly scour the flock for gaps opening up between the sheep. If they see one, they position themselves to discourage any movement of sheep away from the main herd.
No dramas.
It may look like the sheep are looking out for each other, but they're not. When they huddle like this, they're behaving selfishly, ensuring that there is another fellow sheep between them and the dogs. This makes each selfish sheep want to head for the safety of the center, which keeps the whole flock moving in a spiral. Now they have all 500 sheep in one manageable flock, they must navigate them through 3 miles of fields and gates and finally into the pens.
Checkers being the lead dog, he's just come back to the tail to remind the other dogs they have a job to do.
But the dogs aren't on autopilot, and from where they stand, they can't see the whole flock. Farmer David can see everything and knows where he wants his sheep to go. He whistles instructions to different dogs. To the untrained ear, one whistle sounds just like the next. But to the superfine hearing of a dog, the farmer's various whistles mean different things. With a subtle change to the number of whistles, the farmer can make the dogs move to the right, move to the left. Changing the length of his whistle tells the dogs to stop or move forward. The dogs aren't just obedient, they're also good at math. The math of sheep behavior. To illustrate this, Farmer David is going to walk into a flock. It's like there's a force field surrounding him, pushing the sheep away.
If I get any closer, see how they've kept that ring around me?
Actually, this is a mental force field around the sheep. It's called a flight zone.
The flight zone is the distance the sheep would like to keep between you and them.
Get closer than about 10 feet to a sheep and it will move away to keep that safe distance. And those clever dogs have learned to think like a sheep and use it to navigate the flock. The dogs use the 10-foot flight zone to control the direction and movement of the flock. As they sprint up and down the rear of the flock, they edge into the flight zone to force the sheep left, right, or forwards.
You've got to massage that flight zone to within a foot or two so that you get them walking forward.
It's like the dogs and sheep are opposing magnets. And by choosing where to move into the flight zone, they can make subtle changes to the direction of the whole flock. And if they edge even more into it, they can speed up the flock's movement.
That's got them moving a bit quicker now.
Now, Farmer David needs to get the sheep through a single gate.
Here, here. So we're calling them over now because the sheep are going past the gate, so we're calling them over to the right-hand side. Steady.
Moving around the edge of the flock, the dogs steer the sheep toward the fence until one finds the gap in it. Then, because they're sheep, where one goes, the rest follow.
That's it. Job done.
An hour and a half later, and four dogs and one human have counted 500 sheep back into the pen.